introduction. So I would like to thank the organizers for inviting me and giving me to present actually two topics. So I have these actually two which are in some sense connected to presentation of them in a different way. So in of the parts two apologies. So during the weekend it was bored, so and second what group organized well, in some sense in upset with the set of organized Wolfa okay nearly the same in those of you who that they heard that already once. Second part should be new for everybody here. Joined with Anton Kolleck and with Anton Kolleck. So, in the last 15 minutes, and the last one on Carlson activity. So, let's go to the doctor, some more serious, then you have to sheet of the graphic on what measure. So, I mean, it's a check, but I mean, you see most of the names are only short on the internet. And we will be most interested in this column, which actually gets markers. So when it comes to cancer, it seems that the mankind has a big going on. And the success is to discover it quickly. So discover it only starts to measure everybody. With some pure at pain and could be of these things are then measured in your blood and based on them take the sample and the so each patient could be described by you, which could go to billing if you think some projection use once and this is 45,000 number and to the power 4 so you get that number of indices for each patient. And these things, the indices which could be actually. So, first, the most important parts are actually not really interesting because it corresponds to the fact that that was human, which everybody knew in the judge that it must be important, most likely it's not. Was blood and everything. Or more charges. And classical diseases, there would be some other diseases. And these are which are easy to find. With one P, clearly disease, it was already found. And the doctor is not stupid. If patients and then you see the by the human eye. So he would need a computer and process of anything. It's obvious. So calculated is the reason, of course, no, but there is a reason for not one, say a combination position, something like that, maybe so many 5, 20 or something like that, which would be different for the other way around. That's something which is already but just by the human eye. Might be diseases which would be very, very complicated. This assumption is not true. So, indices and the assumption is probably wrong, but reasonable assumption thing. So they would do when human basis. So what is the task is what done, meaning the patient which were and this between these problem and problems groups of problems learning, and there is a lot of about. So if you think that responding paper don't hold is then cited machine, the concept which together look like people. So you got M say more M all described by number. The one in groups try to separate these based on these labels by some plane such that one side the other would clear separate these two groups, the ideal case, it's quite simple. And maybe hyperplane such that for the group of, say, healthy patient, this contact would be zero, and, well, it would become. So you want to do this stable way, meaning x. Classified correctly, which means you stay, take the plane, which is actually quite far from. So here you have a picture which is shamelessly stolen from Wikipedia, which has of course a long page on support vector machines. So this hyperplane is just bad, doesn't separate anything. This hyperplane does separate two groups of patients. Here would be already misclassified. Exactly the same in this case. But because if you perturb the data a bit, everybody gets classified in the same way as before. So here you have it mathematically. If you write it down, you end up with what is called soft margin support vector machine, which is convex. So with about 20 stations, and does exactly what it should. So this size of this W corresponds to the gap between these two groups based on this hyperplane. This penalizes misclassifications on the right side, maximum of this and zero. So if you end on the bad side, you exactly. This line became really world famous. So sort of and paper all that. I will not go into all the details, of course. It's applied. What we shall take care about is that after you run this, typically most of the coordinates are actually a result of this L2 penalty here. So does L1 come in? So for the patients and the doctor and so on, we have group sick patients, we want to there is only we so important. It's important to achieve some real interpretation. Come, we want something we could end. So, 40,000 sheet of paper. Sheet of paper. And why these? Quite natural. So, I mean, 10 years of compression, exactly what to do. So that's a term, sparse here. I mean, a student of basic compress sensing would figure out that in a matter of minutes. There is a quarter machine, the news is it 2000, so just short thing, time where it was not that such a good bet. So put setting exactly the same way, you're healthy, you separate them with a hyperplane, then we only and you are done. Okay, it works. If you change your regularization parameter, you get a trace of coordinates, and you see that if you change one, so if you change that, then you can switch off the number of non-zero coordinates, each one of them, find out how many coordinates actually zero is W. And you see it goes in a way. This is made for advanced support vector machines really popular. So you set your lambda, you run this experiment on your data, and you will this is good for the reason that if the doctor says, okay, my intuition is that there should be seven parameters, and you can see which lambda actually gives you this result. So it might be used. So it's good to see that, for example, there is a pretty big gap between three coordinates non-zero and four coordinates non-zero. So if you are not ready to pay the price for changing the lambda so much, then you say, from this I learned that three should be already quite good. So it's just to pick the to have see what this lambda is actually doing. Of course, some information gets lost, namely the indices, which you can find afterwards. So this non-zero coordinates, really I mean, could somehow label it that this corresponds to some it could actually happen. disappear two new companies. For so as well, the same way, really analog of application where you have much more dimension than they, then of course actually distinguish between the groups which are on the table. Into talking, increase the number of points and converge somehow to the right W, and limit if a point so what is of English. It comes to one obvious question, which patients each patient 500,000 numbers, and I expect to so should I include 100 patients, 1,000 patients, do that beforehand. You collect the data, it might be difficult at first to test and then to start the collecting. I mean, cannot really mention theorems about patients. So, a simplified setting, which, well, patients, on the other hand, allows us. So I will speak next of these two later. So let us assume that there was a separation vector with which is and come into the game without any loss of. Let us assume it was somehow sparse, which we model by this condition. So L1 is small. So if A is S sparse, then R would be of the order square root of S. And assume this unrealistic assumption would be good. So of course, but this model, if the and label correct, so the groups was really given by the scalar product, then if machine mitigation, so that harmless is on the lambda got replaced by R guarantee. So you take the output of this line, the argument of this minimum, and you normalize back to L so that you've got this as well. And this smaller than epsilon plus 1 over r. So what is actually grows in the field. What is most important is the number of you need to train the support vector machine. And you see it grows logarithmic into in the dimension, so if the dimension data, so they now they actually billions. The method is still applicable. Okay, I take the log and it's a fair game and can work. Second, with epsilon to minus, which is unfortunately the price which you see in most of the theorem, all R we would like to have, but we would have to prove another version of L1 support vector machine. And this R, which is the sparsity back again. So that is the criteria. So this R squared, L and D, they are most likely to be optimal, and I think that. But the dependence on is okay. Okay, so theorize that for this simplified setting, asymptotic ratio, have to go with. You've got the error as paper of Yaniv Plan and Norman Berg. So if you think it's you've got measurements. This quantization of these measurements, sign of those, and you analyze, we were not allowed to propose the method, but on the other hand, this game is from the other side, they were using a new method. They proposed as a method of wing. So this is a maximization, it's not minimization, of a linear function of a set is given like that. It's of L2 and L1. And although it's not typical where we typically have minimizers of convex function, it's not the case. It's still unique because the maximizer of a linear function is still on there. For setting one from an so if you take it works every convex. What we've seen actually is namely Gaussian width. Measurements is this such that can as the mean width squared. And for over sparse classifiers, this is, and you see that so this was the theorem was something that would be possible. However, we don't maximize linear function over a convex set. We've got a minimizer of this well, convex but not a linear function. So this is maximum zero. Has really clear to transfer. Nevertheless, so if it's about the proof. So it depends on A in this Y. Y is going to be as your data with the so actually it depends on the for every vector comes you not convex set where both these candidates will block in and minus this is actually positive. This is the fact that these functions, the value of the function really you put in mean quantities you've got here and end up if you now put this to the left, you'll end up in S2. First of that you are able to bound this entity by to bound that from something which is the distance, then you are because you would have the error between A and B. That's the general idea of the work. So the first part is actually quite easy. You use, you know, concentration inequalities to prove something. Don't go into difficulty. And it's easy to detect one. Here it was easy correctly because no symmetrization and the label actually. So it comes actually quite easy. So here it's actually also easy because. Function and found these pressures, which I will not go into detail, but as carefully then you land here. So to observe that if we the data, could so the setting is very convex. So, and now it's more have to grow to infinity. You can choose the sparsity that you get the same error. The error is smaller than epsilon, exactly as they had it. So you improve a bit, at least the fact that you don't need to assume your data actually so think about this result. So you can think about that if an figure out a new algorithm, then L1 SVM on the table would give them the same result. So they also assume that the SIs were chosen to be Gaussian and they so actually you can think about L1 SVM as an algorithm for sensing. That is that the numerical implementation that there is something available optimization of a linear function, which you can very, very quickly. So at the very end, when it comes to implementation, this is probably still a what we did was that we assumed that there is no misclassification. The signs were assigned correctly, where in the work of Roman and Yaniv, that was possible. The and the function had to be with truth, the ability giving the right classification to be larger misclassification. But that was essentially everything what they needed to prove everything. We were able to include up to now. So there is a question about other forms of noise. There is a question. For example, distributions, so everything was done for Gaussian patients, obviously not Gaussian. So, the success machines, and with this we can say if you measure only 100 measurements of numbers, because method would give results. And we cannot really tell beforehand because there is such a big difference, which actually breaks down. So important distribution that still works. I mean, problem of and with that, I will come to the second part of the talk. So this is essentially to do something with collaboration with people from biomedicine, and where we want to experience in the very beginning of collaboration. So where on the next slide or the second relates a couple of ones which were very well studied in the 70s, 80s, geometry of black spaces. Actually, you assign to your black space or in the real numbers of numbers and measure how some information and quality well connects some of these quantities together and allows you them by the other one. To prove some over but what he overlooked what if Olga was writing a book with Simone, you know, the argument he a course. Okay, but the book based on that, okay. Turns out that it's far from the argument actually really works. So I will give you a few details. So you will be very proud if you don't understand. Because that would explain the connection. The aim of the slide is really obvious. Okay, so what are the quantities and inequalities? Let us start from. So, well, that is what I really need, the other need. For example, the image of a unit ball, you know, operator. So ask yourself how such that you can still cover this image with. In the target space. So the concept and really many aspects to work with humans. You cover a set with some sets, volume of the sets which you covered must be larger volume of the set you if you reformulate that you get one entropy numbers typically. Okay, so for go through that quickly. So approximation number just how well approximate your finite rank operator. So the operator but it's finite. So approximate every Tx in a regular way you measure the worst case. So this linear approximation actually involves. So here you take subspace in targets that would be the range of L actually, but from this subspace you approximate in so subtracted It has to be something which my data on X. And the other numbers count. So you choose a large space in your starting space. So actually collects nearly whole. So co-dimensional small. Then there is no approximation of Tx of co-dimension small. So don't see it here. Afterwards. So numbers which got actually used, and I will explain you why. So T then states the following. Got the typical T is about greater Dirac space such that the decay of comparable in a way. So if this goes down and you obtain that these numbers must have cannot be enough. Well, actually, that this implies that k is smaller than sk. True. What you can have. For many reasons. So if you have a look into the proof of Carl, that, well, it has good and bad side. The good side is that first there is proof number very easy. Actually, easier in his convex bodies as a version of this proof, and it fits pages. So you don't need more. The only dyadic decomposition of the you see unicellular series, very nice argument. The trouble comes at the very last line, or last two lines, where really there is no why you reach there is no proof of no this is small. The right doesn't seem to solve the problem because space happens k approximately. The knowledge of Bernd Kadel, he mentioned that surjectivity of for them. So that's the place where the program starts. It's far from obvious, first, that it is, and second, that like quasi-Banach space. So, actually, approximation numbers and Kolmogorov numbers, there is no problem. You just go through the proof of R, you use the quasi-Banach space with some power, through in a matter of hours, you are done. There was actually is in Jena doing exactly this job. Approximation and Kolmogorov inequality for quasi Banach species is really job. But comes to you starts to trick. This is supposed to understand. Construction actually was smart by Kapp and also by PZS helped to look for in this very short argument, and if you write it down, what happens is the following. You know, one line argument for us, normal humans. This is just what you do is you take your target here the dual. So, countable sequences which are by the functionals y. And if you have an element here, you move it to this L infinity by taking the function from this element. So embed you to this very separate space. So L infinity takes by 1 two facts that bounded this interesting. Well, no composition. The proof of Carl's quality is then done in this one line. But the tenth right, you I d quality with approximation numbers, and then you say yes, these approximation numbers are actually right. Get the Carl's inequality with entropy alpha numbers with a constant are done. So, but I mean, there is the trick. One theorem to construct the dual of y at least here. And you need for x to prove this. You used uncountably many times the Hahn-Banach theorem, and then you ask if that works for quasi-Banach spaces, which are essentially characterized by failure of Hahn-Banach. So obviously that's not. So well, actually, in the paper of Simon and Timo and Alain Pajor, there was a claim that it like most likely that the Carl's theorem works for spaces. But I remember when I was in not met actually Ben and Vladimir at some point. I asked the question if they believe the theorem actually holds for Gelfand numbers space. And well, the answer was mixed. So Vladimir Temliakov believes it's not true. It's true. So in that time. So what I mean is if this crazy construction from uncountably many Hahn-Banachs can really be compared to quasi-Banach spaces. For the X space, you need this as well. So you need them both to be Banach. Paper on half of how you prove this, and at least this thing I'm back again. Can go to okay. Well, there was a slide saying that because peers actually most of you know is actually very simple. Some linear measurement recovery math actually all zero if you are in the kernel of the as information only zero that essentially zero. So you can measure are on the kernel A in up with exactly and that's an easy theorem about fun with. So that the quantity of interest, namely the fund, was Donohoe proved, so to say, by a quasi-Banach. Good news, so it was then actually recovered in a on major or used it 10 years ago, actually in now. This with the simple and actually very nice estimates and side since 2 decades, and then estimate the lower bound of these quantities in the same manner. The proof on something like this, which is actually embarrassing. 5 years ago, you know, Holger and his co-authors were thinking about that, and we only returned to that sometime. Identities of final dimension argument from the paper of these four, you know, authors. The fact why some didn't find, you know, so, and with that, thank you. I mean, I'm the expert about that many results on support vector machine learning. So it's Ingo Steinwart about what we are doing around was designed.